video and showing you how to use Duraline. So Duraline is €12 and comes with a bottle like this. It's available in all stores and also online, and there's so many uses for it, so that is what I showed you how to do today. Today I'm going to be showing you the million different ways you can use Duraline. It's such an amazing product and so handy to have in any makeup bag. So first off, I'm going to be popping it in with my foundation. I'm only literally popping in 1-2 drops of this into the AMC foundation from Inglot in shade MW101. What this will do to any foundation is add that lovely glow to the skin. It's great for dry skin if you have dry skin like myself. So popping it in is going to give that gorgeous glow to the skin and make it look super refreshed and healthy. So the next thing I'm taking my Duraline for is to mix it in with the gel liner for my brows. I always pop this into gel liners and brow gels. It just makes them super creamy and makes your brow and gel liner glide on. So again, you need the tiniest amount of Duraline for this. One drop is plenty. And it basically just makes the gel liner not tug at the skin. It just glides straight on, makes your job super easy to do. And the brush I'm using for this is a 17TL from Inglot, which is absolutely amazing for brows. The next thing I always use my Duraline for is to mix it in with my gel liner if it's ever drying out. So the gel liner I always use without fail is a 77 gel liner from Inglot. It's the best black gel liner ever. It's super intense black. It's smudge proof and waterproof as well, so it won't budge for the day as well, which is brilliant. But if your gel liner is drying out, pop in again only one little drop into your pot and it will bring it back to life. It'll make it super creamy, super easy to use, and make your gel liner just glide on, which is amazing. Next tip and trick to use with Duraline is probably one of the best tricks I've ever learned, and that is how to clean up my wing and make it super precise. So I grab a concealer brush, a little bit of Duraline, and then I clean up my wing and drag it outwards. It's seriously amazing. Next thing then, I'm taking a little bit of Duraline in the inner tear duct on a bullet brush with the 123 pigment from the Star New Collection and popping that as my inner tear duct highlight. Duraline is really, really good to stick your pigments with. If you just pop a tiny little bit down, again, you need the smallest amount, and then pack your pigment on top of it. So the next pigment I'm going to be taking is actually a body pigment, and this is number 47, again, from the Star New Collection. So with this one, I've actually put the Duraline onto my lid where I want it to be placed. I like it to place out 75% of the eye, again, packing it down ever so slightly, grabbing the pigment then, and packing it on top, and it will stick straight down to it. Another thing I absolutely love to use Duraline for is to smudge out my wing liner. So instead of getting a black shadow and trying to get the pigmentation that the gel liner has, instead use a little bit of Duraline and I press it against the wing and it smudges it upwards and outwards, which is fantastic. And then I just set that with a bit of 63 eyeshadow with my 10S brush from Inglot as well. The next thing I love using Duraline for is to, I guess, intensify the mattness of our lipsticks. Our lipsticks are super matte, so I find that if you pop a little bit of Duraline on them, it really brings out the pigmentation in them amazingly. Again, you only need the tiniest amount, and it will still set into that gorgeous matte finish if that's the finish of your preference.